Well, even after retiring, you can work. Deb Bernacki with Happier at Home is here to tell us more. Good morning, Deb.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. There are many reasons people might choose to work after retirement. What are some of those reasons, or what are some of the benefits of that?
Well, some people have to work out of necessity for some income, but if you don't have to work, this can be such a fun time, retirement. It doesn't mean let's just stay home and watch TV. Enjoy your retirement, enjoy your second half of your life where now you may be working in something that will help you have fun where you're contributing to society. It reduces loneliness, it reduces depression, and it allows you to engage socially. I mean, those are some of the benefits, but you really need to look at what your motivation is to work after retirement. So you could think of things like you want to share your expertise, you want to help and give back to society, maybe get out and about, or if it's to stay physically active, or even to stay socially connected. Mm-hmm. Looking at each of those things, understanding your motivation, and then kind of backfilling in what types of things that you can do with that part of your life.
Yeah. You also mentioned just, you know, staying connected or giving back. And I imagine, you know, this would be the time to do that because right now, let's face it, you and I, other people maybe in our age category, we are so busy with, you know, other stages of our lives now. We have to work. We have kids, so we have those obligations. Right. So now is a time that people are freed up and, like you mentioned, give back and maybe perhaps more volunteering.
Yep, giving back. So if you're looking at what your expertise is, this you have a lifetime of knowledge. It's
right.
A wealth of knowledge that you could really help and affect people in a positive way. So if you act as a consultant, perhaps, or you work with the SBA and you help people start their own business, those are some examples. But I know with Happier at Home, we hire people all the time that are even professionals, registered nurses, that really love to give back to society. Perhaps the complete income is not always your motivating factor, but being able to give back, that is giving a gift that really helps to enrich your life. So working as a companion caregiver, always connecting with us would be a great idea. But then if you want to get out and about, you like to drive, how about looking into becoming a driver, a courier, or maybe for Uber or Lyft, for an example, something like that. Staying physically active. If you love to garden, do some gardening for people. Become a pet walker, things like that. There's always something that you could help people, and also you're really benefiting from it as well.
Yeah, what are you hearing from people in terms of, okay, maybe they are at that stage in life, they've retired, and how are they feeling in terms of being loneliness and maybe getting involved as a way to combat that?
It's a slippery slope to stay home and not get out. You really need to connect. It's an essential part of our brain and your limbic system that you have to connect. Just like breathing and eating and drinking, connecting socially really helps to enrich your life. It helps to actually, studies have shown, elongate your life too. So why stay home and just be by yourself? Just get out and contribute to society, share your gifts, and it will help you too.
Yeah, no need to isolate. And good reminders for us to engage with what some of these people have to offer because they have a lifetime of knowledge, as you said. Deb, thank you so much for your time. It was good talking to you today. Have a great week, and we'll see you next week.